So, I guess this is it. Years of watching and waiting and hoping, and it comes down to this. Do I love you? Do I miss you? I don't know for sure, I hardly know you. But you're the closest thing to family I've got, and I suppose that's something. Goodbye, Auntie. Wherever you are. What a morning. At least I'm home now.
Hi there.
Hi?
So who are you visiting today?
Oh, ha ha.
Seriously, who are you here to see? I can't let you in unless you tell me.
I live here?
No, you don't. I know everybody in the building. I don't know you.
Who the hell are you?
Jim Birdo.
All right. Jim, where's the regular doorman?
Geez, where have you been? He's on strike.
He's what?
Strike. All the building servicemen in the city are doing it. Union rules or something. I stepped in to help because I know everybody.
How come nobody told me?
Notices were posted all over the building. I put them up myself. If you lived here, you'd have seen them.
Who pays attention to things like that?
Well, that's not my problem.
Please, I've had a really tough morning. I need to get home.
Sorry, lady. Rules are rules.
Listen, I really live here. Fourth floor, number 4E.
4E? Hmm. Isn't that apartment empty?
No! I live there, and I want to go there. Thank you very much.
Oh. Hmm. Maybe you're telling the truth.
He sees reason. Thank God.
Do you have any ID? A driver's license or something?
Yes. I have a driver's license. It's upstairs. In my desk drawer. Crap. Come on, this is New York. Who actually drives?
True, but I still can't let you in unless you prove you live here.
I have my apartment key. Will that do?
Sorry, no. That could be any key.
Well, let's go upstairs and see if it works.
And leave the door unattended? Can't do it. Sorry.
Okay, I have no ID, and you don't know me. What can I do to prove that I live here?
Well, can anyone in the building vouch for you?
I'm not sure. I mean, I don't really know anybody here.
How long have you lived here again?
Be quiet. Not all of us are social butterflies.
Okay, whatever. Hey, what about Nishanti Sharma? She could vouch for you.
Who is this Nish...
Nishanti. Nishanti Sharma. She lives in 4F, you know, right next door to 4E. You really don't get out much, do you?
Your point?
Nothing, but I'm sure she could vouch for you.
Great, call her up.
She's not here.
Of course she isn't, so I gotta wait here all day for her.
You might have to. Although, she usually goes to Washington Square Park in the morning. You can look for her there.
I'll be back.
See you around.
Washington Square. It's been a while since I've been here. Still looks the same, I guess. Although the dog park is empty. I wonder why. Now I'm getting a stress headache. I need to get home. He's wearing one of those extendable leashes. I don't think so. I recognize her from Nishanti Sharma, was it? This is gonna be awkward. That's Nishanti Sharma. My next door neighbor, apparently. She's playing some sort of flute. Excuse? I can't do it. I can't just barge up to her. Not in front of all those people. They're all staring. All right. Here I go. No. Okay, that didn't go so well. I just need to work myself up to it. Okay, you can do this. Right. Crap! Calm down. Need to calm down. Right. This is it. Hi. Can I... Damn it. This is not working. I can't do this. I just can't. No. I can't do this. I just can't. I'll just have to wait until she's finished. Or, I don't know. I can't do this with all those people staring at me.
Oh, for heaven's sake. Don't worry, Moti. I'm coming. There, all better. I can't take you anywhere, can I? Oh, it's you! The lady next door!
Yeah, hi.
Rhonda, isn't it?
No, Rosangela.
Well, Rosangela. I hope my friend here hasn't been giving you any trouble.
That's a cute dog you've got.
Isn't he just? Normally he behaves, but he seems to have taken a shine to you.
Oh, great.
Anyway, I don't think we've formally met. I'm Nishanti.
Rosangela.
So you said.
Oh, right.
Yes?
I have a strange favor to ask.
Go ahead and ask. What are neighbors for?
You know that building servicemen strike?
Yes. Jim Birdo is covering, isn't he?
Yeah, that's the problem, see. He doesn't recognize me.
Oh? Oh. So you need me to vouch for you?
Yeah, I know this is pretty stupid.
Don't worry about it. Moti is getting a little cranky anyway. Let's get you home.
Thanks.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. I just need to get home.
All right. Let's keep walking. Hello, Jim.
Hey, Miss Sharma.
Jim, this is Rosangela. She lives here.
She does? Okay. Sorry about earlier. Had to be sure.
Well, now you're sure. And you must be so proud of yourself.
Well...
Never mind. Just get out of my way.
Well, here we are.
Yes. Finally. That stupid kid.
Well, perhaps. But try not to be so hard on him. We're all neighbors after all.
Yeah, I guess.
Looks like somebody's hungry. I'd best get this spoiled puppy fed. Feel free to drop in any time you want.
Sure, maybe.
No maybes. I know we New Yorkers don't usually talk to our neighbors, but who cares? The city can be a lonely place, especially when you live alone. I've got Moti. Who do you have?
Oh, I have three great roommates.
Oh?
Yes, their names are me, myself, and I. It's a joke.
Yeah, I get it. Very funny. I'm sure you're fine. Although your episode in the park tells me otherwise. And your eyes. Well, let's just say the offer stands.
Sure.
You go home now. We'll see each other soon, Rosangela, I'm sure.
Hey.
Yes?
You can call me Rosa, if you like. Rosangela is kind of a mouthful, you know.
All right, Rosa. You have a good day now.
What a strange lady. Home, thank God. I've never been so happy to see a 500 square foot room in my life. Ugh. Hello?
This is Dr. Quentin from Bellevue Hospital.
Yes?
I was your aunt's primary care physician. Did you receive my letter?
Yes, I received it. I haven't had the time to come by, though.
That's all right. I'm sure you're busy. However, should you find the time today, my entire schedule is free.
Sure. I'll keep that in mind.
Thank you. Good day.
If I don't visit him, he's just going to keep bothering me. I suppose I should just get it over with. It's just a telephone. My computer. It's a bit old, but it lets me access the internet and do my writing. Just a trash can filled with crumpled up novel ideas. I don't need to take the trash out. It's not even full. That's Griff, the PI bear. I've had him as long as I can remember. He's in horrible shape, but I don't have the heart to throw him away. It's fake, but kinda pretty. Out of sight, out of mind. There's nothing in these cabinets I want right now. This is the only living plant I own. I bought it 2 years ago. It's still living, despite my total lack of care. I suppose I should trim this plant. Maybe one day. My window, with the curtains firmly shut. No. I open those curtains and a dozen windows can look directly in here. Those curtains stay shut and prying eyes stay out. Just a standard stove-oven combo. Cook. Why bother when every Chinese restaurant in the area delivers? That leads to my bedroom. It's an oversized closet, but it suits me fine. It's a photograph of Auntie Lauren and me. Auntie Lauren. She took care of me after my parents died. For most of my life, Auntie Lauren was a vegetable, slowly rotting away in a hospital bed. I don't remember what she was like before that. This picture is all I have to go by. It's me. I look scared out of my mind. I don't remember when this picture was taken, but I look about 4 or 5 years old. No. I used to talk to this picture when I was a little girl, but not anymore. When I was a little girl, I'd try to talk to my younger self in this picture. I was trying to give myself advice about the future. It didn't work then, and I doubt it would work now. They're fine where they are. Just some old book review clippings. I am just feeling so uninspired today. Maybe tomorrow I'll feel up to it. But today, it's just not happening.